Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, the immortal Hulk Hogan.
Hey everybody, and welcome back to Talking About the Talkies. My name is John, and joining me as always is the real American, Mr. Stephen Pearson. Stephen, how are ya?
I'm not too bad, John.
Are you eating your vitamins and saying your prayers, man?
I'm always eating my vitamins and saying my prayers.
As we are approaching the 40th anniversary of WrestleMania, I thought we would look into something a wee bit wrestling related here. That happens to be one of my very favorite curiosities of all time. Today, we're going to be talking about the incredible lies of Hulk Hogan.
Oh my God, what an interesting video.
Do you know who Hulk Hogan is?
I do know who Hulk Hogan is. He's that big green guy that does all the wrestling, isn't he?
That's right. He's the incredible Hulk Hogan.
He can't be the Hulk. I'm the Hulk.
He has a reputation of telling outlandish lies.
Yeah.
If you don't know much about Hulk Hogan, you're not going to know anything more about Hulk Hogan because everything I'm about to read out is complete bullshit.
I like that concept.
let's start off here. Hulk Hogan claims that he wrestled 400 days in 1 year. How is that possible?
There's only...
Before I give you the context, what do you make of that claim?
Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday comes again.
I mean, 400 days in 1 year? That's amazing. I don't know how you did that.
How did he do that?
That must be hard on the body, I swear.
The man must have a time machine. He says, since he traveled so much between Japan and the United States of America,
right,
the time difference added up and made it possible that he wrestled 400 nights in one calendar year.
That's like 35 extra days.
But he did it, Stephen.
John, do you believe that we're living in a time where time travel is possible?
I do.
I would never have thought.
I believe it. But also, if time travel is possible, then that could happen at any time period. Because you can travel through time and go there.
Yeah.
Back in 1800, they could be like, oh, Jesus, time travel, that's impossible. But it's like, nah, I'm coming from the year 2050. Hulk Hogan was supposed to be the representative / sponsored in a series of grills that were going for sale. But he missed the call. It was George Foreman then who got the call. He got a call after Hulk Hogan. So the George Foreman grill was originally supposed to be the Hulk Hogan grill. Let me just clarify, by the way, these are all things that Hulk Hogan has said in interviews and claimed to be true. Anyway, next lie here. Next fact here. Let's give him the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah.
Stephen, did you know that Hulk Hogan was supposed to be the bass player for Metallica? First time he said he offered to join in the year 2001 when Jason Newsted exited the band. I don't know much about Metallica. I guess that's a guy in Metallica. And then Hulk Hogan said that I used to be a session musician before I was a wrestler. I played bass guitar.
Okay.
I was big pals with Lars Ulrich. And he asked me, I know who Lars Ulrich is, by the way.
He's the drummer, yeah.
And he asked me if I wanted to play bass with Metallica in the early days, but it didn't work out. Lars Ulrich has since gone on the record and said he has no idea what Hogan is talking about. Hulk Hogan later claimed that he sent in letters, made audition tapes, and tried to make phone calls for 2 weeks, but heard nothing back. James Hetfield, who's the main guy at Metallica, has also said he has no idea what the fuck Hulk Hogan is talking about.
His version of history.
I don't know his version of history. I don't remember him. But anyway, Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, he talks a lot about it. It was a time.
But what is it? He was in the band for a minute?
No, but he tried to be in the band.
I think he's saying that he was in the auditions when you were looking for...
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. Definitely not. But anyway, it's a good fit, yeah?
Yeah, because they have a documentary called Some Kind of Monster, where it documents them getting a new bass player after Jason Newsted leaves, and there's no mention whatsoever that Hulk Hogan has put in any kind of like tape or anything like to try and audition for them. That is so made up.
Did you know that the 2008 film The Wrestler, starring Mickey Rourke?
Oh my god.
Have you seen that movie? God.
Yeah, I've seen it. I've seen that movie, yes.
Very good movie. Fantastic movie, I would
very,
say,
very, very good movie. Yeah, yes. I really liked it. And we studied it.
A fantastic performance from Mickey Rourke. So the 2008 film The Wrestler was supposed to be based on Hulk Hogan's life.
Mm-hmm.
Then he was on... You're not going to believe this, Stephen. You're absolutely not going to believe this. But it is true, I guarantee. It was offered to Hulk Hogan to play the role of Randy the Ram Robinson, but he turned it down, thinking that someone else would be a better fit. So we have a quote here that says, "This movie is so good." This is Hulk Hogan speaking here. "This movie is so good. If you put me in the film as a wrestler, people are going to say, no credibility. Hulk Hogan isn't a good actor." Well, that's the one true thing that he actually says in this whole situation. After Hulk Hogan said this, Darren Aronofsky has refuted this multiple times. "For the record, the role of the wrestler was always Mickey Rourke. It was never Hulk Hogan's, as he claims on Howard Stern." let's move on to the next Hulk Hogan claim here.
Yes.
Hulk Hogan claims that he fought Pride fighters in the 70s and won. So Stephen, you might not know, Pride is a mixed martial arts promotion in Japan.
Uh-huh.
It was founded in 1997. So Hulk Hogan claimed that he fought Pride fighters in the 70s and won. Either implies that he has no concept of time, which we've already established. He doesn't really have a concept of time. Or that he possibly, like people who later went on to be in Pride when they were children, and he beat them up. So who's to know?
That's not a feat worth bragging about, to be
it's
honest.
It's not really something that I would be bringing out as like, well, what's the best you can bring to a job? Well, I beat up some kids when they were 10 years old.
No, he's doing that Japanese time travel again. So he is. He's in Japan in 1997, it was actually 1970s.
Possibly so. Sometimes you get off a long plane ride and you're like, what time is it? Hulk Hogan goes, what year is it? 1975? Five, whatever.
Oh my god. This guy's senile and an idiot, so we'll just let him.
Well, he's not even senile because he's been saying this shit for fucking like years and years and years. This goes back 20, 30 years, some of these claims.
Oh, so this is him, what? I thought this was just recently.
No, this is not him in like the last year having a senile moment every moment of the day. This is like stuff, this folder that I have here has been building up for decades. So we have WrestleMania 40 coming in a few short weeks. The opening of WrestleMania 30 saw Hulk Hogan, Steve Austin, and The Rock all come together and cut one big promo, start of the show. Hulk Hogan has claimed since then that he had no idea that The Rock and Steve Austin were going to come out until their music hit, and he was like, that's his genuine reaction in the ring, is him going, whoa, here comes Steve Austin, here comes The Rock. Anyway, I'm going to cut here, Stephen, to a wee video of them literally having a chat right before the segment.
God. It's about that time, isn't it?
I think it is.
Come on, guys.
You're saving it for out there. He's the money man. He's saving for the red light.
He's like that guy that you went to school with who's like, you know that he's lying.
Yeah.
But like, he refuses to back down.
And I own every kind of classic car. What's that? Classic cars. I own every kind of a classic car because I'm rich, right?
My uncle works for Game Boy and he gave me an advanced copy of Pokemon Red and I have it right here in my hands.
that's so accurate.
Open your hand up and let me see it. No, I can't let you see it because it's illegal, actually. You would go to jail, mate.
Otherwise, the FBI will come and get me. Handcuffs don't even fit because we're like fucking 10.
Because you're 10 years old. Anyway, he claims that he partied with and outdrank John Belushi, famous alcoholic John Belushi, and also drug addict and whatever else, and he died.
Mm-hmm.
But he claimed that he partied with him and outdrank him. He drank him under the fucking table, Stephen, Mr. John Belushi. He said that this happened right after WrestleMania 2 in 1986. John Belushi died in 1982.
You fucking idiot. Plus, like that man's dead, right? Okay, fair enough. Like, sad. Like, it's not like...
Rest in peace.
Yeah, it's It's tough. But he's bragging about drinking an alcoholic under the table. Like, that doesn't make you look good. That makes you look sad.
Oh, man. Anyway, speaking of famous people that Hulk Hogan has interacted with, did you know that Elvis, as in Elvis Presley, you know, the main Elvis, he was a big Hulkamaniac back in the day. Did you know that, Stephen?
I didn't know that, but I'm glad that you're now telling me this, that big man, the biggest, one of probably the biggest pop stars ever.
Aye, back in the day. Elvis, he was actually a known wrestling fan, but by the time that Hulk Hogan rolled around to Memphis, where he's from, Elvis was already dead, long dead by that point.
Yep, that's very accurate to very how much these stories are going.
Very much in the vein of the John Belushi story of, like, me and this lad did this thing. It's like, he was already dead by that point. He got almost got The Undertaker blacklisted. Did you know this, Stephen? No?
I didn't know that, no.
He Hulk Hogan and Undertaker wrestled. Hogan took a tombstone piledriver at the end of that match onto a steel chair. Ooh. Very deadly.
Ooh, yeah.
And Hogan claimed that The Undertaker did the move wrong and he broke Hogan's neck, or nearly broke his neck, and he was laying on Vince McMahon's office floor. But if you watch that match, the replay shows that Hulk Hogan's head was literally nowhere near making the ground. Because Undertaker, apparently, the story goes, he felt terrible about it. He was like, oh my God, this is awful. I've really hurt this guy. I feel so terrible about this.
Yeah.
He came absolutely nowhere near the mat or the chair or anything. He literally just, like, that was the safest possible way about it. And then apparently he confronted Hogan afterwards, and that's when he was like, oh, well, you must have been gripping me wrong or something.
Fucking hell. What an actual idiot. Like, it's just, like, I don't even know what to say anymore
it's
about this
one thing
man.
After another, sir.
Look at this! He's
slamming it! So, Steve, have you ever seen the clip of Hulk Hogan slamming Andre the Giant?
I have, actually.
Yeah, so it's one of the most famous wrestling clips of all time. Like, Hulk Hogan slams Andre the Giant at WrestleMania 3. He says that he was the first person to ever slam Andre the Giant. Andre the Giant had been slammed multiple times throughout the years, including by, insert clip here, Hulk Hogan himself. And that the Giant weighed 600 pounds. He's updated this claim multiple times throughout the years. At one point he was like, he's 400 pounds, and then he was 500 pounds, and then he was 600 pounds. As of his last claim, he was like 650 pounds or something like that.
Right, yeah.
Hulk Hogan had claimed that Andre the Giant would pass away just a few days later. He lived for like another 7 years or something like that.
What?
I wrestled Andre the Giant with these boots on, and then a couple days later he passed on. These are my favorite pair of boots.
My brain is actually starting to hurt. I'm getting frustrated hearing these.
Well, Steven, did you also know that in turn for doing this big slam, this big mad slam, Hulk Hogan tore every muscle in his back? But he never missed a day of work, though.
Oh, no, of course not. Hulk Hogan,
of course not.
He powers on. Like, he have broken his neck with the Undertaker, but was able to go
in. He gets straight back to work, Stephen. He doesn't mess around.
Yeah.
We'll move along to a bit of a sad one here, Stephen, actually. This is probably, like, one of the worst things that he's ever done.
Oh, God.
So Hulk Hogan claimed he was really touched by a Make-A-Wish kid. So he personally invited the kid to come and see him at SummerSlam in 1992, which was in Wembley Stadium in London.
Yeah.
But when he went out to perform that night, when he went out to wrestle, he saw that the seat was empty, and Hogan knew that the kid had died.
Oh, man.
And he recorded a song later on.
Oh, God.
I read it in the papers. I saw it on TV. I guess it'll be one empty seat when I wrestle at Wembley.
So the big problem here, though, Stephen, is that he wasn't even on the card. He didn't appear at SummerSlam. He wasn't even in London. And the whole thing is just completely made up.
So, he made the whole thing up?
Apparently so.
The whole thing. What the fuck is this guy's fucking problem? What the fuck? Why is he like this?
Why is he like this?
What the fuck?
I don't have an answer for you.
That has to be one of the worst things. That there is a ridiculous thing to do, to lie about it and then release a song about it. What the fuck? I'm about to have a heart attack. I feel like I'm not angry.
It's insanity. It's actually what insanity. What a dickhead. Anyway, so this one's kind of... We'll end on a wee bit of a lighter one because that one was really bad.
Yeah.
So Hulk Hogan has claimed to have a 10-inch penis. So you maybe possibly remember the trial that he had with Gawker, the website Gawker, where he bankrupted them and took all their money because they were the ones that leaked his sexcapades, porn, slash racist tirade.
I remember this, yeah.
Yeah, so during that Gawker trial, he was asked in court and, about his 10-inch penis.
You see me bollocks, everything's in order.
Hulk Hogan, as in the character, has a 10-inch penis. Terry Bollea, right, which is his real name. Okay. His real name. Terry Bollea does not have a 10-inch penis.
Well, it's not mine, because mine isn't that size, but we were discussing the length of Hulk Hogan's.
Seriously? So, you
no, seriously, I do not have a 10-inch penis. No, I do not. Okay. Seriously.
But Terry Bollea is Hulk Hogan. Like, he doesn't, like his character
is him.
Might have been, like...
It's him.
Like, it might have been, like, exaggerated for wrestling and stuff.
Yeah.
But, like, for real-life interviews and all that, like, he is Hulk Hogan. Like, he doesn't do much difference. So
absolutely.
That's so dumb. I love that. That's so funny.
Well, thank you very much, for everybody, for joining us in the Tall Tales of Hulk Hogan. If you like this video, then you can always subscribe to our channel. And if you don't like the video... then subscribe to our channel, because we might make a better video sometime down the line that's actually good.
Yeah.
And you like it.
And you want to stay around and see if we get any better.
100%. You want to track our progress. Be a man, Hulk. Come on, don't be scared. You're running from Macho, that's what I heard. Be a man, Hulk. Boy, use a chuck. Cause Hulk Hogan is a real big punk. They call you Hollywood. Don't make me laugh. Cause your movies and your acting skills are both trash. Your movie straight the video, the box office can't stand. While I got myself a feature role in Spider-Man.